Good day, everybody. We're kicking off a series of Tekla PowerFab partner spotlights. Today, looking at the Tekla EPM integration with SigmaNest. We'll spend the next few minutes looking at how Tekla EPM and SigmaNest share nesting and inventory information. I'm Chris Randolph with Tekla EPM and Tekla PowerFab. Joining me representing SigmaNest, we have Ari Brown.
Hello, Chris, and thank you for inviting me to this webinar today with Tekla EPM. I'm very excited to be working with Tekla from the SigmaTech side. We've done a lot of work over the past few years to make the integration more seamless. It's never been so easy to set up and share data within our customers' facilities, all the way from order entry in Tekla, sharing the engineering data, CAD, CAM, out to the shop floor and to the back dock to shipping. All this information can be easily accessed and shared for all the interested parties to make the manufacturing facilities run smoothly and efficiently. So looking forward to reviewing these benefits today.
So Tekla EPM is meant to be the primary data source for your inventory. So what we do is send inventory updates through SimTrans to SigmaNest. This can be done from inventory, but typically will be configured as an automated event.
Tekla EPM also has a report for SigmaNest that allows SigmaNest to send inventory and remnant updates to EPM. This is particularly useful during the setup for remnants that were created outside of the integration.
The nesting process starts with creating a combining run in EPM. The parts are exported as a nesting request to SigmaNest through SimTrans, creating a work order.
In SigmaNest, the parts are nested onto stock, either inventory or orderable. Then results are sent back to EPM so the material can be reserved or ordered.
Now we'll demonstrate that nesting workflow. We'll start in Tekla EPM, creating a combining run. I'll select SigmaNest as my nesting software. Now there are some shortcuts and default settings for some of the steps we'll look at today, both in EPM and in SigmaNest, but for full transparency, we'll take the scenic route. I'm going to filter this down just to make a smaller, simple example. So we've got some 3/8 plate. I'll limit my width and length to 1 foot for the example here. So SigmaNest is going to do the actual combining. So right now this shows as not combined. We'll export the parts to SigmaNest to be nested. Notice the work order number will be 15. There is an option now in the SigmaNest setting setup to allow a custom work order number.
We'll give SimTrans a moment to run. Now we will import the work order into SigmaNest. Notice work order 15. Now we have our parts. We will build our nest. We don't have any sheets in inventory, so we will nest on orderable sheets. Now we'll send our report with the nested details back to Tekla EPM.
Now back in Tekla EPM, we'll import the results. The parts are linked. It shows us that we need to order plate. And we can click View Nest to see an image of the nest and of the parts that are in the nest. When we save the results, we can choose to add the required plate to a requisition or a purchase order. So once the plate's received, we can find it reserved to the project and linked to the nest image. We now need to let SigmaNest know that the plate is available in inventory. The automated event will take care of that when it runs, or we can send an update with an inventory export to SigmaNest. Notice the SigmaNest ID for this plate, FS215. We'll look for that in SigmaNest in a few moments.
Once the inventory is available, the nest is posted in SigmaNest, and EPM can create a cut list.
With the cut list import, EPM checks SigmaNest for what's been posted, updates nests with any new information, and EPM records them as being sent to machine. Now that the nest has been posted and the cut list imported, it can be taken from stock.
After the export is run through SimTrans, back in SigmaNest, we can find our plate FS215 in the sheet list, load it, and then modify the task to use this sheet . Now we're ready to cut. We'll crop the sheet and create a remnant, and now post.
Once it's been posted, in EPM we can import the cut list. Again, this step will typically be automated. This will import the SigmaNest cut list and retrieve the post. We can view the sheet image again and see now that we have remnant information added. And we have a representation of the cutting pattern. Also note the EPM remnant ID. That ID won't change even if the location changes or if the SigmaNest remnant ID changes. A take from stock in EPM can be performed by several different tools. The SigmaNest program update, from color offload, or from the cut list in EPM or from the Tekla EPM Go tablet interface.
To demonstrate the final step, we'll go to the program update button in SigmaNest. Now just keep in mind, this can also be done from color offload, Tekla EPM Go, or from Tekla EPM.
This is also a step that will typically be done by the automated event. Once the SigmaNest cut list is imported again in EPM, the inventory item has been removed and replaced by the remnant, which will be available for nesting. Parts that are cut will have their status updated in the production control job. That completes the process of using SigmaNest as the external plate nesting software for EPM. We've created a combining run, sent it to SigmaNest as a work order, nested in SigmaNest, and updated in EPM when it was sent to machine and when it was cut. I also want to give a quick plug for some new capabilities with the integration. In EPM, we've added part data fields that mirror those in SigmaNest that can include additional information like the combining run ID, sequence, or lot in what is provided to SigmaNest. If you don't have the part data options, please update to the latest version of Tekla EPM.
This is Ari Brown with Sigma Tech Systems. I would like to thank Chris Randolph and the team at Tekla EPM for inviting me and setting this webinar up. For further information on how SigmaNest can integrate with Tekla EPM, please call me at area code 513-335-7432 or email me at ari.brown@sigmanest.com. Our website is sigmanest.com.
Thanks, Ari, and thank you everyone for joining us. Likewise, if you have any questions about the Tekla EPM side of this integration, you can reach me at chris.randolph@trimble.com. Also, watch for more PowerFab partner spotlights in the coming months. Hope to see you soon.